Tickan, what brings you to table tennis? How did you start and how did you become a coach?
First of all, I was a player for many years, playing in the Swedish national team. And after I stopped my career as a player quite early, if you compare with some other Swedish players, I was getting a proposal to start to coach. And after that, I have been interested in the coaching job and been staying with table tennis for many years.
This interview is mostly about young coaches who work with young generation and coaching cadet players. What do you think, what would be the most important if you have opportunity to coach a good group of 12, 13, 14 year old boys or girls? What do you think that's the most important to do?
I think it's a very complex question because it's so many things, but I think one thing is important, that coaches for young players is have a philosophy that the players should be good when they are, you know, senior players. So you work in a long term, on a long term basis. That is very important, because if you are looking for short term results, it can be difficult then to become a good senior player. I've seen so many players, especially in Europe, we have young players who are very good up to a certain age, but then it's very difficult to take the next step to become a very good senior player. So I think it's important for the coaches who work with young players that they educate the players to become very good, for example, when they are 25 or 30 years old.
Okay, and what would be regarding that's coaching philosophy that players would need to accept, but what about content? What do you think that most of the time should players and coaches do on a practice sessions?
I think you should take that step by step, but I think it's important to, as you see today, senior players, as we see here in World Championships, are complete as players. They don't have any weak sides. So it's important to step by step to work with details and start with ground one. You know, I say many times it's like a stair. You know, you have to take every step in the stair up to reach the top of the stair. And sometimes I feel that, especially in Europe and in Sweden, you jump from step one to step four, so you miss some steps. So it's very important to work with all the details. You know, it's footwork, it's backhand, it's forehand, it's service, it's receive, it's spin and power. So it's very
All these elements should be present in very early age.
Yeah, like I said, step by step, you know. So even all the time, you know, you should follow your players and see that okay, now we have managed to get to make this quite good. Then maybe you can start to work with new details, and then you start to work with new details, because I feel that, you know, when I was playing, you know, 20 or 30 years ago, you could have some weak points, you know, in your game, but still be successful. Today, the sport is very complex, and that of course also means that you have to work with the physical part and the mental part of the game.
Okay, what is for your talent, and when you observe players and before announcing his talent, what are attributes, what characteristics you look that you can say, okay, we are talking about maybe cadet, young cadet, that you can say, okay, this is the boy or girl that it's worth spending more time or effort? And
I mean, this is, I think it's very individual. Of course, you have, if you see the top players today in Europe and in Asia, I think you have very many different personalities. So it's difficult to take out, you have to be like this, but I think it's important to have talents in different way. For example, you can have a talent for work very hard, and that's an important talent. You can have a talent to understand details in the work. You know, if you are a coach and you teach your players, you need to have a talent to understand and to to adjust to this advice. So there is many, then you have the talent for the ball, you know, the feeling of the ball, and you have the talent of the how to read the game. So it's many different talents, and I think you don't need to have all these different talents, but you need to have some of them. So you should I think that's
what would be the good portrait of a coach working with that age group. What characteristics should this coach have, or better to say, what would you advise coaches working with this group, what should they work on themselves, not with the players, to become really successful?
I think it's first of all, it's important to have engagement, you know, to the work. You know, you need to love the work, you know, have a big heart for the work, because that means that you're never satisfied, because the player, no coach, even in China, is never satisfied, because then you can find new ways to work with and new things to work with. So that is important, to have a big heart and never be satisfied. Then like I said before, I think it's when you work with these young players, you need to work in a long-term way, you know. You should not stress the players when they are young, and if they have good results, it's important also to tell them that, okay, this is just a small step, you know, we should work, you should be as best when you are 10 years older or 15 years older. So even if it works well or not well, it's important to always try to find new ways and to think in the future, you know, to make things better. So
importance of the environment, players' environment in that young age, and the first environment is for sure family. Recently we witnessed a lot of strange happening when family are taking sometimes too little or too much, and especially in western part of the world. So can you give some advice for parents how to handle this, because they're investing a lot of time, money many times, energy, and also to young players, how to handle the parents, because they get in a coaches and parents and maybe too much advices.
Yeah, of course this is a very difficult question, because you have in the world many different cultures, you know, so I can just speak from my point of view. And I think what I feel is that when I was a player, and this support I got from my family was that they were supporting me in practical things, you know, driving me to the tournaments and giving me food, you know, on the tournaments and like that. But they never had any interest or any, how would you say, questions about my practice or my games. So I think it's good to be a supportive parents, but let the coaches and let the player himself or herself to think about the game more and try to avoid, you know, because a parent have a very big influence of the kids, of course, and that means that if you're not professional or if you push too hard, it's difficult for the young kids to handle it. So be supportive, but stay, you know, a couple of steps behind.
Okay, last question. And you were quite successful at one point with older players in Sweden, but you have a lot of experience also bringing young players into the picture. When is a good time for young players to hit international road, you know, to start competing? What would be the good indication that it's time, that player is mature to test international waters? And what steps should be to coach to encourage players to go that way? Because sometimes it's a measure of winning, losing, you know, confidence. So do you have some message for the coaches regarding the planning and competitions and training for that age?
Yeah, I think also it's important for the coach to always be objective to see how is my player or my players, how do they adjust to if you go start to play tournaments, winning or losing and traveling, etc. But I think it's good to start quite early to both play tournaments, international tournaments, but also to go practicing in different countries or different environments. So I think that's good. But of course, it's all the young players are individuals, so you have to be also aware to see what is best for every individual. But I think there is a point also that it's not only to learn table tennis, to see other countries or to learn other practice methods. It's also the thing that you're traveling and you are staying far away from home, from your parents. I mean, this is also one thing which I think make you tougher mentally. More early you become more tough mentally, which is very important in sports. So
when was your first international, not international tournament, it could be in Sweden, but yeah, traveling outside of Sweden?
But I had a very, I think for me, very important steps in my career. It was when I was 16 years old, I go to Japan for a 2 months training camp in the summer, and I make this for 2 years. So when I was 16 and 17, I make 4 months in Japan. First year together with one friend, Anders Tunström, who is working for ITTF and was a player at that time, and second year I was alone. I think that made me, these 2 years made me a better table tennis player, because I practiced much more than I was used to, but it made me grow as a person also, which made me, yeah, I think in the near future there to take better steps in my career, better decisions.
But that was not your first international tournament, Japan. Did you start earlier or?
I mean, I was quite late as a player. I was not good as a cadet, so I was not picked for the national team like that. So I was not away that much before. Maybe some single tournament or something like this, but not so much. So I was late, and this things was good timing in my career.
But probably you know the history of this golden generation. Can you tell us what time was approximately when Erik Lind, Anders Waldner and others started?
Yeah, I think we maybe at the age of 15, 16, 17, like this, we go to, before of course we played some tournaments, you know, in Europe, but at that age we go to China or to Japan for long training camps, and I think that was important things for all these players to come to the best, especially China, to the best country, to learn from them, but also, you know, to live in a different way than at home, and to become more tough mentally. So that in this age, 15, 16, it was for this generation.
Thank you very much.